Good evening, everyone. Myself, Sushma Chandrasekhar. I am working as a guest lecturer in Botany Department of ADB First Grade College, Harappanahalli. In this video, I am going to explain about evolution of sporophytes in bryophytes. Before going to the actual topic, let me define what are sporophytes. Sporophytes are the spore-producing individual phase in a life cycle of a plant with alternation of generations. It is a diploid multicellular structure which is derived from a fertilized cell or zygote by simple cell division and subsequent differentiation. The primitive cells are going to show alternation of generation type of life cycle. In such kind of plants, sporophytic condition is a phase where the spores are going to be developed. Zygote is the mother cell of sporophyte. The sporophyte is going to be formed by the continuous cell division and differentiation takes place in the zygote. The evolution of sporophytes in bryophytes can be studied by studying the following theories. First one is progressive theory of evolution and the second one is retrogressive theory of evolution. The progressive theory of evolution was first described by Bower in 1908 and he was supported by Kevers, Campbell and Smith. Retrogressive theory of evolution was first put forward by Kashyap in 1919 and he was supported by Church, Gobel and Evans. Let us know in detail about these two theories. Progressive theory of evolution. This theory is also called as progressive sterilization theory of evolution. The principle of this theory is the progressive sterilization of potentially fertile cells. According to this theory, during evolution, the primitive and simple structured sporophyte undergoes accumulation of sterile tissue, leads to the development of advanced and complex structured sporophyte. ಈ ಥಿಯರಿಯ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ರಿಕ್ಷಿಯ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಇದು ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಆಗಿರುವಂಥ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಈ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂಥ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅವು ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ನ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ನ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಟೈಮ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಕ್ಷಿಯ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾದ ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಆದರೆ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ರಿಕ್ಷಿಯ ಸ್ಪೀರೋಕಾರ್ಪಸ್ ಟಾರ್ಜಿಯೋನಿಯಾ ಮಾರ್ಕೇನ್ಷಿಯಾ ಪೆಲ್ಲಿಯಾ ಆ್ಯಂಥೋಸೆರಾಸ್ನಂಥ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಟೆರಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂನ ತಮ್ಮೊಳಗಡೆ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಈ ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಜಿನಸ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಯಾವ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಜಿನಸ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಫರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಆ ಫರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸು ತಮ್ಮ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿಯನ್ನು ಕಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ ಹಾಗೆ ವಿನೇರಿಯಾ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸನ್ನು ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ ವೆರಿ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಫರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಆರ್ ಫರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಸೀನ್ ಇನ್ ಫಿನೇರಿಯಾ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಕ್ಷಿಯಾ ಅನ್ನೋದು ರಿಕ್ಷಿಯಾದ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟು ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಹಾಗೆ ಫಿನೇರಿಯಾದ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟು ಅಡ್ವಾನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ದಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎವರಿ ಸ್ಟೇಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎವರಿ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಬ್ರಯೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಕೆಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಸ್ಕೆಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಯೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಕ್ಷಿಯಾ Rickettsia sporophyte cannot be differentiated into foot, seta and capsule, because here in this case foot and seta is absent. This is not seta, this is the gametophytic tissue. This is the globose capsule covered by single layer of capsule wall or jacket layer. This encloses sporogenous tissue. All the sporogenous tissues are involved in the formation of spore tetrads through meiosis. For example, 100 sporogenous cells idave anta helidre aa ashtu 100 sporogenous cells enagta irutte anta helidre aa ella cells kuda spore tetrads formation maartirutte. All these 100 cells are fertile in nature. No sterile cells can be seen in Rickettsia. The sterilization continues or comes in spirocarpus. The sporophyte of spirocarpus is differentiated into bulbous foot, narrow seta and globose capsule. Kelavond textbook galalli Rickettsia matte spirocarpus na ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಸಿನಿಯ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ಕಾರ್ಸಿನಿಯ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ನಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಣುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸು ನರ್ಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ನರ್ಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ದೀಸ್ ನರ್ಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೆರೈಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ನರಿಷಿಂಗ್ ದ ಡೆವಲಪಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್. ತುಂಬ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ನರ್ಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ನ ನಾವು ಕಾರ್ಸಿನಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು. ಕಾರ್ಸಿನಿಯಾ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಬರುವಂಥದ್ದು ಸ್ಪೀರೋಕಾರ್ಪಸ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್. ಈ ಸ್ಪೀರೋಕಾರ್ಪಸ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿರುವಂಥ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಸೂಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಜಿನಸ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಜಿನಸ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂನಲ್ಲಿ ಉದಾಹರಣೆಗೆ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ 100 ಸ್ಪೋರೋಜಿನಸ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಜಿನಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ 80 ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಫರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ ಟೆಟ್ರಾಡ್. ಓನ್ಲಿ 20 are involved in the formation of sterile cells. Sterile cells idralli sigutte. Ee sterile cells yav reethinalli irutte anta helidre they are spherical in nature and they are unicellular and they are directly formed from the spore mother cells without any meiosis, which means these sterile cells are diploid in nature. The sterilization continues and it can be seen in the another bryophyte, that is Targionia. The sporophyte of Targionia is differentiated into foot, seta and capsule. Foot is bulbous, seta is slightly elongated and having elongated globose capsule. In this Targionia, the number of sterile cells are more than spirocarpus. For example, 70% of the sporogenous mother cells are involved in spore formation, whereas 30% are involved in the formation of sterile cells. The number of sterile cells are more in Targionia than spirocarpus. These sterile cells are slightly elongated in nature. After the Targionia, the sterilization continues and it can be seen in the sporophyte of Markentia. The Markentia sporophyte can be differentiated into foot, seta and capsule. Foot is slight bulbous, seta is elongated, massive and capsule is globose in nature. This capsule encloses sporogenous tissue. This sporogenous tissue is responsible for the formation of both spores and elaters or sterile cells. The most important characteristic feature of Markentia is an extra layer is going to be present, which is going to protect the sporogenous, which is going to protect the sporophyte. This is known as pericaecium. Another most important characteristic feature of a Markentia is presence of elaters. Elaters are the sterile cells formed from the sporogenous mother cells. These elaters or sterile cells are elongated in nature and they are having spiral thickenings on their surfaces. These spiral thickenings of elaters are helpful, or the elaters with the spiral thickenings are helpful in dehiscence of capsule after the formation of spores. In Markentia, For example, 50% of tissue, total tissue of sporophyte is fertile in nature, whereas another 50% is sterile in nature. The sterilization is well developed in Marchantia when compared with the Targionia. The sterilization continues in the next bryophyte, that is Pelia. The Pelia is having more amount of sterile tissues than that of Marchantia. The sporophyte of Pelia is differentiated into foot, seta and capsule. Foot bulbous in nature, seta elongated, and globose capsule is going to be present. In Pelia, the capsule is protected by wall layers, and these wall layers are bilayered in nature. The capsule encloses sporogenous mother cells, and those sporogenous mother cells are responsible for the formation of spores and elaters. Another most important characteristic feature of Pelia is presence of elatophore. Elatophore is a structure which is going to be present at the proximal region of capsule, responsible for the formation of elaters. These elaters are helpful in dehiscence of capsule. And extra sterile layers are going to be protecting the sporophyte is also in another characteristic feature of Pelia. In this Pelia, about 60 to 65% of a tissue in the total sporophyte is sterile in nature, whereas about 35 to 40% of a tissue is fertile or involved in spore formation. The sterilization continues in the next stage, that is anthoceros. In anthoceros, the sporophyte is horn-like in shape. It has bulbous foot region. The seta is going to be absent. The seta region is going to be captured by a special kind of tissue called meristematic tissue. This meristematic tissue is responsible for the indefinite growth of the capsule. At the center of this capsule region, it is having about 16 rows of elongated parenchymatous cells. This region is called as columella region. This columella region is sterile in nature and helpful in conduction of water. The epidermis is multilayered, having some of the spaces, those are called air spaces, through the stomatal regions. The archisporial cells, which are present at the distal end of the capsule, are responsible for the formation of sporogenous cells or spores and tetrads. The percentage of sporogenous tissue is about 30%. Whereas the percentage of sterile tissue is about 70% in case of anthoceros, or it may extend about 80%. 80% of sterile tissue can be seen in anthoceros. Only 20% of fertile tissue can be seen in the total sporophyte of anthoceros. Anthoceros elaters are not called as elaters, they are called as pseudo elaters because they are not having any spiral thickenings on their surfaces. They are plain in nature. The sterilization continues in the next plant, that is Fineria, which we are noticed, that is, it is the advanced sporophyte according to the progressive theory of evolution. The sporophyte of Fineria is differentiated into foot, seta and capsule. The capsule is very complex, and this capsule is again differentiated into parenchymatous, apophysis, capsule wall, and the hypodermis region. In these three regions, hypodermis region and apophysis region are green in nature due to the presence of chlorenchymatous tissue. In this region, the sporogenous tissue is going to be present. This sporogenous tissue is going to give spores in the empty spaces, and these empty spaces are called as spore sac. These spore sacs are going to be disrupted by the trabeculae regions. At the tip, it is having a operculum region. This operculum region is helpful in the dehiscence or dispersal of spores. Not the dehiscence, it is dispersal of spores. At the time of maturity, or at the time of dispersion, the peristome teeth, which is going to be present at the opercular region, gets detached, and thus how the spores are get ejaculated into the environment. In this Fineria, about 90% of the tissue is sterile, only about the 10% of the tissue is fertile. So the simple sporophyte of Rickettsia undergoes accumulation of sterile tissues or sterile cells during the time of evolution, leads to the formation of the complex sporophyte as in case of Fineria. So this is about the progressive sterilization theory of evolution. The next theory is retrogressive theory of evolution. This theory was exactly opposite to the progressive theory of evolution. Principle of this theory is the percentage of sterile tissue goes on decreases during the time of evolution. According to the progressive sterilization theory of evolution, the percentage of sterile tissue goes on increases, whereas retrogressive theory of evolution, the percentage of sterile tissue goes on decreases during the time of evolution. According to this theory, Fineria sporophyte is the primitive one having complex structure by the accumulation of sterile tissue, with the more amount of sterile tissue. This sterile tissue at the time of evolution going to lose the sterile layers. Decrease in percentage of sterile tissue leads to the development of simple sporophyte as in case of Rickettsia. So according to the progressive sterilization theory of evolution, Rickettsia is the primitive one and simpler one, whereas Fineria is the advanced one and complex one. But according to the theory of evolution, that is retrogressive theory of evolution, Fineria is the primitive and complex, whereas Rickettsia is the advanced one and simpler one. So this is about the evolution of sporophyte in bryophytes. Thank you.